We are going to drape the close fitted dress, and we are using the black fabric so that we immediately have a good silhouette visible. So the measurement that we need, so we have to measure the of course we are doing the symmetrical dress, so therefore we are draping only half. So you measure from center front to the side seam on the hip line and add 10 centimeters, 10-7 centimeters to your fabric measurement. So in case if your bust, so the distance between center front and side seam bigger than the hips, so you have to go from here. So measure this and add 7-10 centimeters. So 2 centimeters is folded as usual, yes, for the center front. And before we start draping, so I created guidelines on this fabric with the tailor chalk, which is the bust line and the hip line. So you just measure the distance between them, 2 parallel lines perpendicular to the center front, and you also mark the apex point, so cross mark the apex point, measure from here to the apex. That's it. So this is what we need. So, and we immediately start draping the dress. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to connect bust line on the fabric piece and pin into the center front. So here I attach to the bust tape, so and the apex point. Right, and then the hip line. So the length, of course, you know, we are doing the short version of the dress, actually a very mini dress, basically a torso. So, but you, of course, you can expand and have a longer version. So, and of course here, when you mark the bust line, you have to measure from this point, the neckline, on the shoulder neckline cross mark, crossroad, and then add also some centimeters, 2-3 centimeters also. This will be your bust line indication. So what I'm going to do now, so here we have the, so I'm adding more pins in the center front, right, and we are doing the close-fitted dress, therefore you have to think of the fabric you are going to use. I advise now, for the condition we currently have regarding fabric, the best is having the fabric with some spandex. So blended fabric or with added fibers, so spandex, let's say 5-10% of spandex will be good. And then you don't need to add additional ease on the side seam. You just drape and have your patterns immediately. So, and you see I'm now draping very tight, basically. Not so tight, but still I have some ease, of course, right? I'm not pushing the fabric. With consideration that our fabric has some spandex, right? And I'm not bringing extra ease also on the bust area. If you have the fabric, consider different fabric, with plain cotton or plain synthetics thread. So then you have to consider the ease and have some ease added when you connect with the bust. Just for example, like this. So about 0.7, 1 centimeter, depending on the fabric. So now let's work. So we start draping from the neckline. Draping the neckline is nothing special, so you have to do the certain seam. So I cut away a small piece and then I go from you can plan immediately the neckline. Yes, so now I'm going to make the basic neckline. However, if you have some ideas in mind, open neck or something, or whatever neckline you want, you can mark on the dress form, attach the draping tape and follow the draping tape, right? If you have some idea already in mind. I'm not, so I'm going to use basic neck. So I go towards the neckline with slashes, smoothing the fabric up and pin into the neckline till the shoulder and smoothing the fabric up like this. Right? So now we drape the shoulder. So same thing, right? One of the pin goes into the point where the neckline meets the shoulder, right? This one. Then we smooth the fabric up from the bust up here and we find the end of the shoulder here. So two pins, that's it. Shoulder is straight line. So I will mark now the neckline with the choke, so we have it marked and the shoulder. And the shoulder, end of the shoulder. So just cross mark here. Enough. So on the table we are going to just draw a straight line between two points. So how do we fit the dress? So there are several ways to fit the dress. You can use various darts. So we have to fit the bust, the bust, and we have to fit the waist, right? So to fit the bust, we can consider options. Bust dart coming from the ankle, bust dart coming from the side seam. We are not using the neckline eventually, right? Because now we have it already draped, so and I'm not advising, in case you have some special ideas, right? So we are going today to use the French dart, and I will explain why. So now, before we start working on the French dart, which will happen in this area, I'm going to drape the armhole. So we have some parts, and I will go towards the arm plate, the edge of the arm plate. And I start pinning on the way. So again, if you have, so I'm using the basic armhole, so therefore I'm just following the arm plate shape, right? Not so tight, so you have to look at the way how you drape, especially in this area. So it should not be tight. And my armhole comes 2 centimeters down the armplate, so somewhere here. So and now I'm going to, the apex point should be pinned. So now I'm going to unpin this part. So to be able to drape further, and I'm pinning into the armhole. So my point is here, so I have to fix it immediately here, right? So we have the armhole finished, and I will mark it now. Just points, you don't need to make a line. And now we come to the side seam. This one, right? So side seam starts at this pin level, right? This is the side seam position, the beginning of the side seam. So now we look at what we have. So this point, the side seam on the hip line is fixed with the pin. Now we have that much of fabric hanging here, an excess, let's say, and we are going to make a French dart. French dart is actually a very steep direction, having a very steep direction. It can start actually anywhere on the side seam, close to the waist, a little bit up the waist or even more down the waistline, right? So, and let's see what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to use look at the position, right? So I'm going to create dart here. Just try first. So, for example, this position, so I'm going to bring all this excess so that we will have a smooth side seam, you see? So the intake is important. When you have the intake in your hand, yes, so make sure that the side seam will be smooth, right? No excess of fabric. And let me see the side seam here with the side seam. So in my case, it's about 4 or 5 centimeters up the waistline. So, and I will mark now the side seam. So I just follow the side seam from off the dress form and transfer the side seam. So, and actually it's even palpable, so it's almost visible. So we have the bust dart. Now you look at your, you see I didn't even cut slash the side seam because it was easy. My fabric is quite thin, so it's easy to fit. Let's make sure that we are carrying the right amount. So, Now we look at this area. So if you still want to make more fitted dress, you can consider a dart in this area. A dart is often away from the apex position. So let's make it here. Not on the princess line, but two centimeters away, and it's not big, so and it's a fish dart, and the way how you fit it depends on what you want. If you want more fitted dress, so let's make it, for example, more fitted. So you have to have the pin in the side seam and in the center front on the waist to be able to decide what kind of fit you want. So, and it will be down the bust line, let's say about 2 centimeters. So, something like this. So, I'm fine with my work, so I feel satisfied. And the dress is fitted well, which is very close fitted. So, I like the dart, the position of the dart. So, and now I can transfer my dart onto the fabric, right? So we mark it here. So here our bust, our French dart starts also 2 centimeters away, right? This will be the point. So we mark the direction. So we will mark on both sides. So we will mark on both sides so that we have clear dart intake, right? And we mark the pins, the position of the pins to mark the. So about 10 centimeters from the waist, because our duct is small. So that's why it should not be long, right? It will not be nice. So the intake is 2 centimeters here, full intake. Basically that's it. So we finished the front. So check whether you mark everything. So neckline, shoulder, 2 points, neckline, shoulder, and the end of the shoulder, right? The armhole is marked, the bust dart, side seam is marked. So here a little bit, I repeat this one, so I will mark it. So the initial one was more, was less fitted. So, and it's done. So we remove the fabric piece and continue on the table. Basically what we need to do, just put the fabric piece on the table, unpin if you still have pins on your darts, so unpin everything and true up the lines and remove unnecessary seam allowance. That's it. Mark the waist, yeah, we forgot. So we have 2 guidelines here, and so we transfer the waist onto the fabric piece. So as well. So for the back, we also have the piece prepared, which is again measured on the hips or on the bust for the width of the fabric. With 7-10 centimeters added to the measurement, so from the center back to the side seam, or from the center back to the setting on the bust, right? So depending, as I said. So, and we have two guidelines here. One is cross back, or the shoulder blade line, and the hip line. That's it. So it's both lines are perpendicular to the center back. So, and I placed the fabric already, so I connected the center back with the shoulder blade line. So my shoulder blade is here, so I'm going to connect with some little ease, so just easy, right? So I'm not going to add extra ease here. Normally we drape when we drape the basic dress, sheath dress, we have to add at least 0.7 centimeters to this one. So I'm not doing so. So connect it till the arm plate, right? And I make sure that it stays vertical, right? So the center, I'm not going to pin it now. Maybe only on the hips. I'm not touching this part here. So we're going to drape the top part first. The neckline. So we drape the slash towards the neckline, pinning into the neckline. I have small seam here till the shoulder. So we finish on the shoulder point, so shoulder neckline crossroad, right? Finish. Let's mark it. Till the shoulder line. So we have the point shoulder neckline meeting point. Cross mark. So now we are going to drape the shoulder, and we have to consider the shoulder dart eventually. So our shoulder dart is located approximately on the princess line area. So, and to drape the shoulder dart, so you have to smooth the fabric from this point, from the shoulder blade point, shoulder blade line, so smooth the fabric up, pin the shoulder end point first, and you see you have some extra ease here happening during this procedure, so it happens by itself, right? So it happens naturally. So this ease happens naturally, and we are going to use this excess of fabric into the bust dart, into the shoulder dart, approximately on the princess line position. My shoulder dart is very small. And it will end, so princess line, so it will end somewhere 7 centimeters from the shoulder line. So this is the end. Really small. Not more than 7 millimeters. Like this. So, and I'm going to mark it on both sides. So, and then we have the end point. So, and I will transfer the shoulder line here. So, just mark a few points. So, and then we mark this part, so the armhole. We have the basic armhole as well. So the top part finished. So now what we are going to do. So basically in all close fitted dress we normally have the zipper at the center back. Sometimes it happens on the side seam. I don't recommend. Center back seam position is preferable. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create, to add some intake here. So I will cut on the waist line location. From this folded edge, 1.5 centimeters further. And now I'm folding this part and we'll connect now from this pin on the shoulder blade with this part here. Right. So by doing so, we are fitting the center back. So now our line jumped a little bit, which is clear. Why? Because we fit the waist. So, and I will do this here, the same thing. The center back seam is fitted. So let's continue. And now I will connect. So our line jumped. So and I will finish. So I will continue pinning it. Making sure that the hip line is parallel to the floor. This is what you have to watch. So now we drape the armhole. Remove some fabric here. Slash towards the edge of the arm blade. Pin. So the side seam position is 2 centimeters down the arm blade. So we did it already for the front. So we should come to the same location. So just moving the fabric down like this and pinning. So this is my point here. So now I'm going to slash on the waist. So now our task is to fit further, the back. So we're going to make a dart here and to fit the side seam. Start from the dart. The dart, the location is approximately on the princess line. 3 centimeters, 2.5, 3 centimeters, the intake, don't make bigger. So we finish the dart first. So Basically, you can also make the dart stays vertical, so you have to then create kind of line, the intake. So don't make it very fitted in this area, not more than 2.5 cm, not more than 3. Not more than 3. Like this. And next, so now we use the scissors, so slashing towards the side seam carefully. You see this point also jumped, change the position of the pin here. So now we fit the side seam. Smoothing the fabric and pinning into the side seam. This point. Change again. So it's very smooth, very good. So basically the fit is very nice. So now we are going to transfer all the lines, so we further continue with the armhole here. So we should come to the position, the right position of the side seam, which is this pin, and transfer the side seam onto the fabric. So, and then the dart. So the intake. So here normally it happens to the bust line. So this is the bust line. You also mark it. So the end will be here. And the intake, as I said, not more than 3 cm total. Of course, it's more up the hips, so the finish here. So we should mark also the new position of the center back at the new line. So 1.5 here, right? We fold it inside. So make sure everything is transferred. Finished. New position of the hips. So that's it. So, and the waistline, of course. The waistline position is added as well. Finished.